Bien.
¿Todo bien?
Sí.
Good morning, internet. It is 8:26 in the morning and welcome back to the channel. Yesterday I may have mentioned that the weather is really good here in the mornings and bad in the afternoon. And it looks like I kind of jinxed it because, yeah, it doesn't really look good today. Especially, I think, if I go around the corner here, it doesn't look very good. But the thing is, I also don't want to stay another day here for two reasons. First of all, I mean, I'm staying at a gas station on the side of the road. There's nothing here, so it's not a very inspiring place to stay another day. Plus, it is no guarantee that tomorrow is going to be any better. So I'm just going to go today, see how it goes. Hopefully it will stay dry and not too crazy. It is already very windy, so I hope it will be okay with the wind. What else? Oh yeah, and almost forgot. Breakfast around here was, again, typical Argentinian breakfast. Coffee with pastries, so I'm still hungry and I don't really have much food with me anymore because yeah, there's not really a supermarket around here, so I'll see how it goes. Hopefully I can find a place somewhere to have a lunch. I still have a little bit of fruit with me, but let's see if that gets me through the day. All right, I am now on the Ruta 3 at the gas station in a hotel. So this is the detour that I made yesterday to see the petrified forest. And the plan of today is to ride a little bit on a provincial route around here, which should be a dirt road, I think. And then I have to come back to the Ruta 3. Then I can catch some other dirt road following the coast around here. And then I'll probably spend the night somewhere in this area, which is, there's a town called Puerto Santa Cruz, which is somewhere around here. And the plan is to stay the night there. But let's see how the day goes.
Well, actually, now that I'm here, let's fill up on petrol, because you never know when you're gonna find some next. Let's go here. So that was only 2 kilometers on the Ruta 3. Wow, look at that sky. Let's hope it stays dry. I have these special made earplugs, and you can change the filter which is inside. So now I actually have the strongest filter in, and I wouldn't recommend doing that when you're riding in the city, for example, because then you want to pick up on traffic around you. But around here, it is so much better for my ears to protect it against wind. So with this really strong filter, it's much better. My ears are much better protected, and there's no traffic anyway, so I don't have to hear a car or something.
Thank you.
trees. Baby Nandu. See him run? Oh, there's one. Baby Nandu. Look at that. Just amazing. And I think the most amazing thing of riding here is that you're just the only one. There is nobody around here. And I really don't get it because it's super stunning here. It's just me and a bunch of animals. For me, riding wise, this is just amazing. A dirt road, beautiful scenery, and just that feeling of riding somewhere where almost nobody comes. I think that's what makes it so special. And that feeling, I can't capture that on camera. But I think if you're a rider and you've been riding by yourself in an area like this, with nobody around, you must recognize that feeling. I think especially coming from the Netherlands, you don't get this, you don't. Or in India, you know, there's people everywhere. Even when you're riding in Ladakh, you will not be by yourself. Unfortunately, the wind is very strong here, so I can't fly the drone. That's a pity, but.
Come on, Dad.
Bien.
Todo bien.
Sí. Es dueño de esta estancia.
Un poquito más allá.
Ah.
Falta un poco.
Ah.
¿La sola?
Sí.
Queda un ratito nomás para llegar a la ruta. 20 kilómetros.
Me encanta manejar acá. Tan lindo.
¿De dónde venís?
Holanda.
¿Pero ahora de Deseado?
No, ahora un hotel de cerca de YPF en ruta 3.
¿Entre cerros?
Sí.
Hay unos lugares más lindos más atrás. Si hubieses entrado por Deseado.
Ah.
Más.
Ah, Puerto Deseado.
Desde Puerto Deseado esta ruta llega hasta acá.
Sí.
Hay lugares ahí más lindos.
Ay, sí, ayer mi plan fue ir a Puerto Deseado, okay. Pero fue un día muy largo y estaba cansada, entonces, sí.
Está bien.
Sí.
¿Hasta dónde vas?
Hoy hasta Puerto Santa Cruz.
Santa Cruz.
Sí.
¿Calafate?
Sí, 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 también. Voy a Ushuaia.
Ajá.
Y después...
Llega la vuelta por la 40.
Sí, hasta Alaska.
Queda un ratito.
Sí.
Muy bien. Buen viaje, suerte.
Gracias. Adiós. Mucho gusto.
Well, I was just telling a whole story of riding here by yourself. And then you meet somebody. That's nice. You look like a proper gaucho. Only not with a horse this time. I'm back on the Ruta 3. This wind is madness. Let's go for detour numero dos of today. I've had enough with the Ruta 3 and all the wind, it's insane. Looks like I found a pretty nice spot. Cool, eh? And I'm a little bit protected from the wind, so I could fly the drone, which is nice. So, it is now almost 12 o'clock. Time for my lunch. And I have one more orange, that's it. But it's not too bad because it's only 190 kilometers to Puerta Santa Cruz. So I should easily be able to make that. I'm gonna follow this dirt track along the coast for a little bit more. Then hop back to the Ruta 3. And then I'm almost in Puerta Santa Cruz. Let's go.
At the color of this water. This is just unreal, isn't it? Look at it. Incredible. And guess where I am? I am not in Puerto Santa Cruz, but I am in Rio Gallegos. Gallegos, something like that. Which is a lot further than I was thinking about this morning. And it's been a super long day. And so I decided to treat myself. And I'm gonna stay, I think, in quite a nice hotel. Because, wow, it is now... Because it is now 5:30 in the afternoon. It's been such a long day. I don't even know how many kilometers I did in total. Probably around 500. I'll look it up when I'm in a room. But. Acá. Ah, sí. Muy bien, gracias. Pongo el moto y vuelvo. Gracias. Ah, perfect.
Check out this room. Oh, this is amazing, amazing. I'm so happy that I found a nice place to stay with good Wi-Fi because I've really been struggling with internet lately. Where I stayed last night was just, yeah, I really didn't want to stay there anymore. It just smelled like sewage the whole time. So I'm really happy that I found this place. And also because I'm really quite tired, I just looked it up and I did 530 kilometers today. It's absolutely crazy. Well, I was thinking this morning maybe I'll ride to Rio Gallegos, where I am now. But then I thought I don't want to make the same mistake as last time, and I had some off-roading planned, so I thought maybe I don't make it. But then, yeah, just before the turn-off to Puerta Santa Cruz, where I was planning to stay the night, I saw a sign to here saying 240 kilometers, and I don't know, suddenly I was like, yeah, okay, I'll just continue. And it was not too late, it was 2:30 at that time, so I thought, okay, yeah, I can make it. And then I just continued because, yeah, that stretch between Puerta Santa Cruz and here, I already knew it was just going to be Ruta 3. There was not really anything interesting to see and not a lot of off-road tracks I could see and explore. So I was like, okay, I just have to follow the Ruta 3, and the wind was just so strong. It was insane. I couldn't record anything because I had to keep both my hands on the handlebar at all times. I was just leaning against the wind like that because it was just side wind all the time. I was just leaning like that. At some point, I couldn't overtake trucks anymore because, yeah, if you want to overtake a truck, at the moment that you're beside the truck, it feels like you're being sucked into a vacuum or something. And then you just go all over the place. So at some point I decided, okay, it's too dangerous to overtake trucks. And I can't switch the camera on and off. And I also couldn't stop anymore. One time I tried to stop. But just standing still, the wind just took over. And I could barely hold the bike. So I was like, okay, just keep on moving, keep on moving. So yeah, I just did that 240 kilometers just boop, in one go. And so, yeah, it was a really long day because now it's like 6 o'clock. And yeah, I left at like 8 in the morning or something. So, yeah, crazy day. I didn't stop at all. Only where I flew the drone and had a muesli bar. That was my only break of the day. And then to get petrol, that was it. And I didn't stop. I didn't take a rest. I'm just like, burp, burp, burp. I'll show you on the map where I am now. So this is where I left this morning. And then I did my little sidetrack over here and then came back to the road. Then did my second detour somewhere around there. And then I just blasted all the way here to Rio Gallegos over here. So that also means that this is my last stop in Argentina for now. Because in my next ride, I'm gonna cross into Chile. Because there's this weird little Chile part. So Argentina is not connected here and here. So you have to cross through Chile to reach this part of Argentina and to reach Ushuaia, which is all the way down here. So because I'm now here, yeah, my next ride, I'm gonna cross the border into Chile and then yeah, see right around Tierra del Fuego a little bit, Fireland, and then continue towards Ushuaia. So that's the plan. So I'm actually looking forward to my first land border crossing with Dano. That's gonna be the first time. I'm looking forward to it and spending a little bit of time in Chile before going back to Argentina. And then it'll be kind of like probably Argentina, Chile, Argentina, Chile. I'll be like border hopping quite a bit the coming time. That was it for today. I'm absolutely shattered. I'm gonna take a rest here, work on some videos. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. And then I'll see you in Chile.